The big band era of the 1930s and 1940s has laid the foundation for modern pop and rock music in many ways. Here's how you can get the drum sound typical for that great musical period. If you think about your typical jazz kit today, you might have a 4-piece kit with 12 and 14-inch toms and an 18-inch kick drum in mind. But back in the day, legendary drummers like Gene Krupa, Louie Bellson, or Buddy Rich would have never played drums that small. Usual sizes were 22 or 24-inch bass drums and 13 and 16-inch toms. Krupa, for example, occasionally also went for larger bass drums up to 28 inches and liked to add an 18-inch floor tom as well. To give you an idea of the sound they went for, we prepared a 4-piece Sakai Trilogy kit with 12 and 16-inch toms and a 22-inch kick drum. Just like drums back in the day, the 3-ply shells feature reinforcement rings and round bearing edges. The shell setup is completed by a 6.5 by 14-inch Sonor AQ2 snare. To imitate the calfskin drumheads usually used during the big band era, we went for Ambassador fiber skin drumheads on toms and, for a little more articulation, a Diplomat fiber skin on the snare. Fiber skin drumheads are well known to feature a similar warm and full tone as the original calfskin heads. With Coda Diplomat as bottom heads, the toms are ready to suit the needs of this style. For the bass drum, we went for a warm and open sound, with 2 Ambassador coated heads as batter and rezzo head, and installed a felt strip at the rezzo side for some muffling. Now let's talk about tuning. The bass drum is tuned medium-high with the rezzo head being slightly higher than the batter head. The felt strip is installed at the rezzo side only to make it sound good and articulated in front of the kit where the mic or the audience is placed. The open batter head delivers a clear tone and lots of low end. The toms are also tuned medium-high, so not as high as bebop toms, for example. We went for a clear tone to cut through the music, and the relation between the batter and rezzo heads is used to control the sustain. Just as with the other drums, the snare is tuned medium-high. The thin Diplomat drumhead provides some extra articulation that helps to stay precise even with low volume playing. Still, the snare cuts through the music, and rim shots played close to the rim bring up a nice tone. We didn't use any close mics to capture this kit. 2 overheads in a Glyn Johns setup, a large diaphragm condenser for the bass drum, and a ribbon mic for a mono room are more than enough. In the beginning of the big band era, drummers used to play smaller cymbals. Earlier trap kits usually featured splash cymbals and the lowboy, which evolved into the hi-hat we know today. That's why we used 2 10-inch splashes as hi-hats and an 8-inch A splash. Our classic big band kit is completed with a 19-inch Zildjian Karapi. Let's use this kit to play one of the classics, Sing Sing Sing. Heavily influenced by the second line style from New Orleans. Throughout the following decades, the music evolved and playing the swing pattern on the right cymbal became the standard. The cymbals also got larger. We prepared a second kit using the same shells and drum heads but with a different cymbal setup and a 5x14 Rogers Dynasonic chrome over brass snare. Still having to cut through the huge big band sound, splash cymbals and smaller crashes were used. Here we use a 16-inch A crash and a 10-inch A splash. The 20-inch K ride we used here is rather thick for good articulation and a precise attack. We also changed to 14-inch hi-hats and added a 20-inch swish knocker for some texture. Here's how this kit sounds with Louie Bellson's song 24th Day. As you can hear, the hi-hat and ride are the timekeeper for the whole band, and the snare and bass drum have more of a secondary role. That's totally different from today's backbeat-driven pop and rock music. Which cymbal setup do you prefer, and what is your favorite shell configuration for big band music? Let us know in the comments and press subscribe for more. Now go ahead and have fun recreating this iconic drum sound.